yourself? Why are you so proud of yourself? You are, you know, however much you may grin and say that you are not. It's not the uniform, and it's not the badges. Those are all swank, and a scout is not swanky, though he may be proud. I think you are proud because you know this, that although you are only a boy, you can, through your training as a scout, do a man's work and show a man's pluck when the call comes. You proved this in the Great War. 28,000 of you took up the duties of coast watching, and others of you did other duties in your thousands, thereby releasing a large number of men to go to the front. 100,000 of you who were old enough, or nearly old enough, joined up and went on service. 10,000 never came back, but gave their lives for the country. Jack Cornwall, B.C., was a Boy Scout, and so were 11 others who won the Victoria Cross. Those are the things that make you proud of being in our great brotherhood of scouts. Now, those of you who are tenderfoots or second class must remember this and carry out your motto, be prepared. That is to train yourselves to be strong, active, and clever. Because then, if at any time you are called upon, you know you will be able to lend a hand and do man's work for other people and for your country. I don't mean that you should train especially to be soldiers or sailors, but to be what is better still, good, useful, cheerful citizens. That is what you should aim for. Practice the scout law in your everyday life. Don't merely know the law by heart. Do it, and you will be happier boys and better men. Think daily on your promise as a scout, to do your duty to God and the King, to obey the scout law, and to help other people at all times. Good luck to you, and good camping.